Appearing in films like Point Break, Speed, and The Matrix, along with directing the recent Man of Tai Chi, you can't fault Keanu Reeves' dedication to well-constructed and fantastically entertaining action films. And that is something he continues with John Wick. Following the death of his wife, John Wick is a broken man with nothing left to live for, until a puppy turns up at his house. Ordered by his wife just before her death, the puppy quickly comes to represent all that he has lost, and gives him something to love. That is until Theon Greyjoy appears, and here's what happens.
And, killed his dog.
Oh.
Seriously, the death of this puppy made me sadder than the entirety of Marley and Me, and you can't wait to see how this guy is going to exact his revenge. Luckily, he happens to be an ex-hitman. The film begins with a flash forward from the end of the movie as a promise to the audience that yes, shit will hit the fan. It takes a while for the action to start, still when it does kick off, it is worth the wait. The gunplay in John Wick is almost always excellent, the geography is well established, the cuts motivated by the action rather than the other way around, and the choreography is slick. Altogether, it makes for some extremely entertaining action sequences. Even the CG blood looks good. The world the film takes place in is a sort of heightened reality, one where there is an entire underworld of assassins with their own code and currency. They hang out together, compete against each other, and respect each other, for the most part. It makes the almost comic book style action more believable, and you accept that someone could do this, for instance, as it happens in a world we aren't familiar with, but one that is explained well. They pepper great little details throughout each fight to show why Wick is so much more skilled than everyone else, but also you almost always feel that every fight could be his last. He makes popping headshots look so effortless you think he's got aimbot turned on, but he often comes up against new and unique bad guys that very nearly get the upper hand on him. He gets his ass kicked a lot, be it by one-time Wonder Woman Adrianne Palicki, or even just a random henchman that puts up more of a fight than expected. Unlike a film such as Shoot 'Em Up, that tried to make every gunfight in the movie completely batshit crazy and thus hard to believe could ever happen, however heightened the reality, here it is just over the top enough to be innovative and exciting, but still feel visceral. Part of that is also due to the careful construction of each fight sequence. In the hand-to-hand sequence, the choreography is tight, but still natural looking enough to feel real. The framing also always allows us to see the face of who is fighting, and the cuts deliberately paced enough to help us to see what is happening. Even in a film where everyone dresses the same, you're never confused as to who is who. The variety of haircuts does help that too. The gunfights have similar dedication to coherence, and even the most chaotic of the action scenes is still easy to follow. After Wick breaks into a church run as a front for the bad guy, he goes out and sees his enemy has arrived on the scene. Rushing in to kill him, you feel like Wick has let his emotions get to him and may get hurt, and the camera is shakier and the cuts faster here to reflect that. This change in style is driven by the narrative, and yet it is all still comprehensible. The geography isn't established as much as usual in this scene, but then the idea is that he has gone in without taking his time to observe the environment. We aren't aware of the exact locations of the bad guys, but the film helps us by having Wick always fire left to right and then fire right to left. This is all we need, and the one time Wick breaks to fire the other way, it is because he has exposed himself, leading to this. It shows just how important carefully constructed cinematic language is in fight scenes. An adherence to rules like this can make even a scene of absolute mayhem coherent. It's hard to fault John Wick when it comes to action, and all I can say is that I hope Hollywood look at this as a touchstone for smaller scale but visceral and easy to follow action. Films like The Raid show just how effective and thus popular well done small scale fighting can be, and the guys behind John Wick definitely took inspiration from that, but they've also really made it their own. And it's a beautiful film too, and a lot of fun, and I highly recommend anyone give it a look.